Hiya folks, I just wanted to bring to you this air hammer from US Pro. It's an 8596 air hammer. Let's have a little look at it. Right, well this is it. I've had this for a couple of weeks and it's been good because I've got this for one purpose only, for the pointed end, because I use it to take off the flywheels on lawnmowers. But it does come with a selection of stuff. Let's show you what we get in the box. So you get these four chisel attachments there. One's like a V-shaped one. That one's a little bit shallower there, as you can probably see. That's your standard chisel, and then you've got your pointed auger, whatever you want to call it. So they're the four things you get. You actually get this tool as well. This tends to confuse quite a few people. I'll show you how to install that in a minute and what it actually does. And this is the actual gun itself. There's two models. This is the large one of the two. And as you can see there, it's US Pro, which is previously Bergen. Those of you who didn't know, US Pro took over Bergen, and that's why it's called US Pro now. And all it's got is one entry point there for the chisels to attach, as you can see via them little shafts there. And also the trigger, which on my one is actually missing. I'll tell you for why in a minute. You've got your air supply there, which you're supposed to oil daily. Whether you do or not is up to you. And then you've got this little, I think it's a pressure, so you can increase or decrease. I just leave mine fully open. So anyway, that's the tool. It's a nice, chunky, substantial looking tool. So let's see how you actually put on this bit and what it's actually for. Right, first of all, obviously the bits in question just slide in the end there. But as you can see, they would just slide out. So what you need is this little contraption here. And this has the ability to hold in the chisel of choice by the end of this screw adapter there. And the way you get this on, this is where people normally get confused. They try to hold it like that. They start turning it on there. They might even turn and persevere and persevere. And then they might try and push that one. If you try and push that one, you're just going to hit against the wall, because that just tightens around it. The purpose of these two tags, this one you use to wind it on, and as you're winding it, it actually opens up the spring, because you're actually detensioning the spring, which makes the spring increase. So basically it winds on nice and easy. And then when you want to take that off, you don't use the same one, because when you turn it in the opposite direction, it's tightening the spring up, you see. You then need to use this one, and that again has the same effect by opening the spring up so that you can withdraw the spring. So you don't actually put this on first. I just wanted to show you that, but that's what these tabs are actually for. The top one is to wind it on, and the bottom tab there is to actually wind it off. So first of all, you need to choose your weapon of choice, and I always use the pick tool. So you put that on first, and then you slide your spring over the top there, and you start obviously to wind it on. And this little bit of U-bend around there stops the actual flange from shooting out of the gun. So you just wind it on. Only takes a second. And once it's down, that's it. The job's on now. So, and as you can see, that cannot now come out of the gun. So that's it. We'll connect up an airline. So I have one here. There we go. But unfortunately, because my clip actually broke, it must have been a faulty one, because I'll show you for why. So as you can probably see, that's the trigger, which sits in there like that, and it would normally sit like that, and it rotates on that little pin, that roll pin that sits in there. And as you can probably see, mine broke off right on the pin swivel, so to speak, like that. Now I've tried gluing that and it's not worked. I tried it with super glue and also another special glue, but again, because it's a high tension point, that's where all the pressure comes, it actually kept breaking. So basically I went online looking for one of these. I tried typing in US Pro, I tried typing in Bergen, US Pro air chisel, and I couldn't find anywhere at all where you can actually buy these pieces. So that brought me to a standstill. It was a shame, because it was a lovely tool. And then I was looking around my workshop, and I had a Hiker air ratchet. And lo and behold, if you can probably see there, this trigger is basically the same as the one in my air ratchet, as you can probably see there. So the size looks near enough identical. There's a few slight bodywork changes, but it looks to me that though that's the same one. So I'm just gonna knock this roll pin out here, take out this switch, because I don't actually use this very often now because I've got battery operated ones. And then I'm gonna try and actually fit this one into the Bergen or the US Pro. So let me do that now. Right, okay, so I've got a little roll pin here and I've got to punch it out. I've got a little punch. I'm hoping it's just a matter of knocking this one through. I hope it fits, because that would save me, because I don't actually use this. So there we go. So there we go. Let's have a little look at it and see if it's the same looking thing as the one that's broken. So as you can probably see, there's the Bergen one, or the US Pro one, and this is off of my Hiker gun. I don't even know whether you can get Hiker spares, to be honest with you, so that's something I will look into. It looks to be pretty similar, so I'm going to do no more but to try it. So let's move that out of the way. Let's bring the US Pro in again. It's a shame, because this is a very good tool, you see. I've used it and it does exactly what I need it to do. So I just want to knock through that roll pin there. Okay, maybe I can push that last bit through. There we go. Well, that's the thing in there. Let's see if that lines up. I'm hoping so. It looks to line up. So I'm gently going to tap that through. There we go. Right, okay, so that pin is in. So this is the telltale moment. Oh well, I think that's going to work. I think that's actually going to work. Let's plug the airline in. Right, okay, let's get the airline. Plug that on. And here we go. Oh, that's really powerful. I don't know whether you can see the throw on that. And does that change the... does it make that softer? Oh yeah, so... can you hear the difference? Wind it fully out. Oh, that's really powerful. So that's it, that's the Bergen tool. And what I use it for, I put it on the top of a flywheel on a lawnmower. I put a little lever under it and give it a quick, and that allows me to do that. But as you probably see, it's got them three other ends as well, as you can see there. Ideal for small masonry work or brickwork or whatever. I'm not too sure what the little cutout on that one's actually for. Maybe for pulling nails out or stuff like that. And as you see, you've got that other one there as well. So that's it. That's the Bergen Air Hammer, or US Pro rather, because it's called US Pro now. As you can see, it's an 8596. But do be careful. I couldn't find that switch anywhere on the internet at all. Now that I know Hiker fits it, I may look for Hiker now and see if that actually, they've got a spares department which you can get in contact with. So there you go. That's the little air hammer there from US Pro, the 8596. I'm very happy with it. They do it in two sizes. I think this is the 190mm or something like that. I can't quite remember, but there you go. Hope you've enjoyed this little review on this one. I know I've not shown you it really working, but I'm sure you can see that the power it's got. Anyway, don't forget, if you do like our channel, Butler's Empire, do click on the subscribe button and ring that little notification bell, and that way you get notified every time we upload a video. And also check out my other channels, Retro Hacks, where I do restorations on things like this, for example. This is an old 1960s toy truck, tin plate truck, which I've restored on there, and many other things. Or you might want to have a look at my Retro Restore channel, where we restore and tinker about with cars, motorbikes, other stuff as well, things of interest. And that's my three channels there. Thanks very much. Hope you've enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next video. And until then, bye for now.